Good morning, dear students. I am Sarojini, your English teacher. In the last class, we have discussed page number 3, and in that page, we have seen how Tom was acting for not going to school, and he even woke up Sid, who was in the next bed. Now, let us see what had happened next. So, keep your eyes on the lines when I start to read and listen carefully when I explain. So let us begin. Tom, what's going on? Asked Sid, frightened by the noise Tom was capable of producing. No response. Hey, Tom, what is the matter, Tom? Tom mourned out. Oh, don't say, don't juggle me. But I must. Don't ground like that. Tom, it's awful. How long have you been grounding this way? Hours. Oh, don't say it. I'm dying. You can see how beautifully the conversation is done between Tom and Sid. As soon as Sid woke up, he just asked Tom, what was the matter and why he is behaving like that? But Tom did not give any response. Again, Sid asked Tom, what is the matter? Please tell me. But here Tom said, please don't disturb me, don't juggle me. But again Sid asked, please don't do like that, it's awful. Awful meaning is terrible. And again the question was asked, how long have you been grounding this way? But here Tom said, hours. Oh, don't say it, I'm dying. This Tom is telling that He is just dying due to the pain and he is groaning for the hours. Now let us read the next line. No, Tom, you ain't dying. It makes my flesh crawl to hear you. What is the matter? I must call Auntie. So you can see as soon as Sid asked him means him refers to Tom. Tom is telling that I am dying. But Sid said, you are not dying, Tom. I am just dying due to your voice. Makes my flesh crawl. You can see it is underlined. The meaning is to make someone feel disgusted. Because the sound which is made by Tom, it's very terrible to hear. So Sid said that, no, now I must call Auntie because I cannot control your voice, how you are shouting. Now see the next para, what it has been written. I forgive you everything, Sid, said Tom in a fresh bout of grounds. When I am gone, you give my window sash and my cat with one eye to that new girl who is coming to the town and tell her. But Sid had flown downstairs and informed Aunt Polly, come quick, Auntie, Tom's dying. So you can see here how Tom is behaving. He is telling that, okay, you don't worry about me. If I am gone, gone refers to when he die. You just give all my window sash and my cat to that new girl who is coming to the town. But here Sid did not hear anything. He just went to the downstairs and called Auntie quickly. Now see how Aunt Polly is going to tell. What rubbish, I don't believe it. But the poor lady hurried upstairs with Sid and Mary at her heels. Her face grew white and her lips trembled. You can see how she's worried about Tom. Aunt Polly is very much worried about Tom. As soon as she heard about it, she just went to upstairs with Mary. And she was in a worried condition. That means she is in tension. By hearing those words, you can understand by this line. Her face grew white and her lips trembled. By this you can understand that she got afraid of Tom. Now see what the question is asked by Aunt Polly to Tom. What's the matter with you, Tom? She cried. Oh, Auntie, my toe. What is the matter with your toe? Oh, Auntie, my sore toe is going to fall off. See how beautifully he is just replying to Aunt Polly that his toe is paining a lot. And now See how the expression is given by Aunt Polly in the last paragraph. The old lady sank down in a chair with relief. She laughed a little, then cried a little, then did both together. This made her feel better. She said, "Tom, you really did frighten me. Now you stop this nonsense and go get out of your bed." From this, you can understand that Aunt Polly got a little bit relaxed by hearing those sentences said by Tom. She just sat down on the chair with a great relief. She just laughed a little, as well as she is just thinking about Tom's behavior. And she understood that Tom is now acting for not going to school. So he said to Tom, "Please, Tom, just stop this nonsense work and get out of your bed." See how beautifully it has been described, the conversation. So, dear students, let us see in the next class what is going to happen. Goodbye. Thank you.